Good morning, friends. This is again JV Shivakumar here, and today actually I like to discuss as per the request from our friends. So I'm trying to create a video on how to clear SAP MM certification, right? Actually, so I mean, because actually due to my past experience in SAP ECC and the older versions of SAP, right, for starting from 4.68, 6B and 6C, and then 4.7 versions, right? Actually, 4.7 enterprise version, and then business suite with ECC, business suite ECC 5 and ECC 6, and till the current S4 HANA. So we have come across different generation, because S4 is a fourth generation, right? We need to tell us a generation, not a version, right? So as part of that, actually, say so current examination they are conducting, right, actually for the ECC EHP 7. So that is C_TSCM 52_67. So it's the current version where ECC exam certification exams are conducted. So we have actually S4 HANA certification, right, actually sourcing and procurement also there, but I like to discuss about the SCM, that is VSCM 52_67 certification, ECC certification. So as already told, the total hours is 3 hours, 180 minutes, and they are asking 80 questions for the examination. And again, I'm telling, don't see the clock in the right hand side of the screen. So when it gets incremented, your BB also get incremented. So don't see that, instead of concentrate on the questions. Say some, I already told, actually some of the questions have 3 correct answers and some of them have 2 correct answers. So you need to read carefully on each questions and against the answers, right? So which fits to the requirement. Say if they are giving 2, then you need to check which answers, multiple choice, is correct. So that is very important. And don't get tension, actually feel more relief before attending the examination. As already told, actually during the examination you are not allowed to do any digital device, laptop or palm top or any digital device near to you, near to your premise where you are taking the examination. No standby laptop should be kept open, and then actually no cameras, nothing, and you should completely close your room, and actually nobody is when trying to enter during the examination, nobody is allowed to hide inside. Some people actually, if they are doing fraudulent actions, then actually the your examination will be terminated. I mean, you are not allowed to write the continue the examination. That is important. And say the people from SAP will continuously monitoring you through the webcam. So before writing an exam, you need to be more caution in preparing your laptop with the proper webcam, proper audio and video quality devices, and your internet, right, broadband should be maintained with proper speed. So all these things will be checked by the SAP during the software installation for taking the examination, and then actually the video software, chat software should be on, and you need to switch on your webcam, then actually audio device, everything. And say you need to be present, available for the examination. Say if you are booking for the slot 9 PM in the evening, so you should be available 8:30, and during the 8:30 you need to check with your the coordinator from the SAP when the start exam option will be triggered or initiated in the examination hall in your screen. So normally actually before 15 minutes actually they will initiate the start examination link. So you need to, after preparing everything, you need to click that, and so you need to share your screen and then audio device, everything. Screen share is allowed, and so through that actually they will monitor all your 360 degree room of the where you are sitting, right? You are going to write the exam, so they will monitor everything, and then actually they will ask you to show your identity card. I mean, either Aadhaar card, other two ID cards actually, with the home address, naming, everything. So Aadhaar card or driving license or PAN card. So then actually say if any naming difference, you need to show the third ID. I mean, if it is, if you are having passport ID, passport with you, so you can show that. So and actually no pencil or pena should be there, and your mouse pad should be clean. There is no text on that, and there is no actually other than laptop or power source, there should not be any device or paper, text papers with the text, nothing is allowed. So they will ask you to show left and right, and your opposite side actually where you are sitting to write the examination, right, and your back side, everything you need to show, and then actually so that should be accepted by the SAP coordinator who is conducting the exams. So then after that actually they will read the rules. They will ask what screen they are seeing. Then if it will get a loading screen and then instruction. So you need to accept all these things, whatever they are orally said, you need to accept all the examination information related to rules and instructions, and then you need to start the examination by clicking start, and actually one by one actually the questions will appear in your screen. So you need to be thorough actually in reading the course content, right. Actually it is available in Learning Hub Access, SAP Learning Hub Access. If you are having, actually you can download the material and start studying on the course materials. So important thing you need to know is actually you need to carefully study the org structures, assignment, org structure assignments, and the same one to multiple assignments and everything, and then actually the purchasing document categories, document types, item categories, account assignment category, and then actually different types of procurement like consignment, subcontracting, and then actually the outline agreements, concepts of outline agreements, and then what are the automatic source determination process, source list, quota arrangement, so whether it is considered for the MRP run or not, so what are the documents generated from the MRP, and say we are related to reservation related questions, and then actually they will ask you on the inventory management, say what are the types of inventory stocks and what are the different types of stocks, that is unrestricted, blocked or quality, and what is a GR blocked stock, what is a restricted GR blocked stock, so what is first of all actually GR blocked stock, so all these concepts you need to know, you need to study very well, and actually how the transfer posting happens, what are the internal transfers happen, and say what is the assignment between the material types and evaluation classes, what are the important things or important criteria where material type will determine, what are the factors to determine, or how the industry sector will guide you or take you to different controls, how the number ranges are controlled, how the document types are mapped. So if you want to create a new purchasing document, what assignments to be carried out, and then actually how you are posting the GR blocked stock, and then actually what is an account assignment category, how you are grouping the different plans with respect to the valuation grouping code, how it assists you to determine the account assignment category, what is a valuation class, valuation string, and what are the valuation modifiers. So when stock is posted to consumption, what will happen? And when stock is posted to, issue to scrap, or I can say take out for cost center, take out for scrap, what exactly happens for the consumption accounts? And what is an enterprise portal? How you are connected to the SAP without connecting through the guy or anything? Actually, you can, wherever your work, actually you can able to connect your enterprise portal to SAP ERP softwares. And what is the persona settings, and what is the difference between S4 HANA and the ECC thing, so then actually what is an RTP stock, and then actually what is the stock transport orders, so what is the main difference between the stock transport order and the we have different categories, right, so what are the transfers happen, and when transfer happen, which accounts will get debited or credited. For the consumption, what will get actually say the stock account is debited or credited. Like that, actually account assignment categories and all these questions will be asked. And actually generally actually say what is the assignment, how the MM is linked to the WM, and then actually how WM in MM is will be integrated to the other areas of SAP modules in core ERP. So how MM and FI are integrated. So these are the important questions, and particularly we need to study about the special procurement, that is consignment, subcontracting, stock transfers, and then actually firmware orders and everything, and inventory management, valuation, automatic account assignments, and especially how you block your particular purchase documents. So what is the purpose of release strategy, and what are the controls available in the release strategy, why we are using release group and release characteristics and everything. So what generally what documents will get generated during the MRP run, that is planned order, purchase requisition, scheduling order, all these things, right? Scheduling documents and everything. And so what are the different types of contracts, then actually field level settings, say how, what is the sequence where actually by which the screens can be controlled, and say related to vendor master, master data means material master related questions, and then actually which screen you can control, what are the material master related operations you need to you are performing, and what are the, what is the use of account group, how it is controlling the vendor in vendor master and everything, and what are the settings you are performing. So you need to carefully study what are the settings to be required in the purchasing screen of the vendor master and the company code level client view, and say what are the things where the condition reports are maintained, what is the pricing procedure, how far actually you are utilizing the pricing procedure in determining the particular price for the material, at what level actually you are assigning the pricing procedure for the MM purchasing organizations and everything, and then actually how the batch is determined at what level, and what is the criteria for doing the automatic POs, where the settings can be done. So these are the main focus areas you need to learn, and then service entry sheet, how the service entry sheet and service acceptance so are related, and the difference between the service entry sheet and the GR, and what is the assignment between this account category, reference valuation class and material type, and how you are determining the price, right, moving average price, and what are the corresponding settings, and you need to more concentrate on account postings and everything, that is very important. So you need to know the concepts. So these are the main areas of focus in MM. So I think actually I already told actually the EWM part of the examination, and so today actually I have told about the MM part. So next thing will be, I mean first thing actually you concentrate on actually the org structures and everything, as already told, that is very important. Master data, then procurement type, special procurement, and different types of orders, what is purchase requisition and related thing, and source list, then quota arrangement, automatic source determination process and everything, inventory management, different types of stocks, and how the stocks are handled, what is the consumption, what is the stock postings, and automatic account determination process. Everything you need to know about the detailed process of all the MM concepts and everything. And as already told, actually in SAP is providing actually the certification actually. So either you can pay some 50,000 plus GST, and that includes somewhat around more than 60 plus amount, and which is having the code CER006, which there you can write a 6 times examination, and CER001 is one time examination that costs 16,889 plus GST of 3,000 plus, so totally it is coming around 19,889. So you can write one time or 6 times, that depends on your interest and your confidence in clearing the examination. So all these things matters. And next thing actually So one thing actually, whether it is a SAP MM certification is easy or not, then I can say it is more easy, and if you are having hands-on experience, it is much more easier to clear the examination rather than studying the concepts, right? So studying is somewhat different from the working in SAP, right? From SAP working, you can easily get the knowledge and you can easily clear the examination at a single shot, right? So that is important. So please try to prepare for the examination and write the examination and get success in the SAP career. Thanks, friends. So I hope actually I have given all the details related to SAP MM, C underscore TSM 52 underscore 67. This is for materials, SAP ERP material management, ECC EHP 7. So thanks, friends. Thanks for watching my videos.